Why the travel nurse scandal is worse than you thought. Recently, it came out that the Furey Liberal government paid nearly $36 million over a five-month period to travel nurse agency Canadian Health Labs. Nurses were being paid upwards of $300 an hour, over six times above the local standard rate. However, some of that money also went into paying for nurses' cable TV, Walmart furniture, pet transportation, and even in one case, an air fryer. Tom Osborne, Minister of Health and Community Services, tried to point the finger away from the Furey Liberal government. But we have proof that this deal not only started in the Premier's office, but was seen and signed off by Furey's Ministers of Health and senior officials within the department. Jordan O'Brien, a Liberal lobbyist for Canadian Health Labs, started the communications by contacting Ken Carter, an advisor in Premier Furey's office. It then went to Health Services, where the deal with the CHL was signed with approval from the Minister of Health and Community Services. Canadian Health Labs is owned by Bill Hennessy, an entrepreneur who made huge profits off gaps in the system created by the pandemic. Hennessy's company even went so far as to hire nurses away from the public system to get paid more in the private sector, which was paid for with taxpayer dollars. Minister Osborne personally extended the Canadian Health Labs contract, yet is acting like he had no idea what was going on under his watch. Why are the Liberals giving so much money to a private company instead of investing in the long-term recruitment and retention of nurses? Why are they pointing the finger when they knew about and negotiated this contract from the start? Why are they still withholding important information from the people of Newfoundland and Labrador?